This is a presentation covering experiments done by Marshall Nirenberg, Johann Matthaei, and Philip Letter, created by Emma Mackowsky. We will start with Nirenberg and Matthaei's experiment. Marshall Nirenberg and Johann Matthaei wanted to see how an E. coli cytoplasm would synthesize proteins when RNA was added. They used cytoplasm to create a cell-free environment, which would ensure no interference from biological processes associated with the cell's contents. They placed E. coli extract in 20 test tubes, each test tube containing all 20 amino acids. A different amino acid was radioactively tagged in each test tube. Matthaei then added synthetic RNA known as poly-U, made purely of uracil, to each test tube. Translation took place in each test tube, and a protein was precipitated. The proteins were then filtered and checked for radioactivity. If the protein was radioactive, then the labeled amino acid must be in the protein and the codon codes for that amino acid. This step was repeated for all 20 amino acids, each time having a different amino acid labeled. In this case, the test tube containing the labeled amino acid phenylalanine reacted on the filter, meaning that UUU codes for phenylalanine. Repeating this process, they were able to find that CCC coded for proline and AAA coded for lysine. In conclusion, Nirenberg and Matthaei were the first to discover that a specific RNA sequence coded for a specific amino acid. We will now cover the experiment conducted by Nirenberg and Letter. Nirenberg and Philip Letter made the triplet nature of the genetic code clear and deciphered the remaining ambiguous codons in the genetic code. They did so by creating a mixture containing a trinucleotide, also known as synthetic mRNA, with one codon, a ribosome, and 20 charged tRNAs with amino acids, one amino acid in the mixture being radioactive. The mixture was mixed and allowed for binding to occur. The ribosome bound the mRNA and the tRNA specified by the mRNA. After binding occurred, the mixture was then passed through a nitrocellulose filter. The tRNAs bound to the ribosome-bound mRNA were caught in the filter, whereas the unbound tRNAs passed through it. The filter paper was then checked for radioactivity and for which amino acid had bound. If radioactivity was found, then the trinucleotide codes for that specific radioactively tagged amino acid. In other words, that specific codon specified that amino acid. In this case, an mRNA with GUU was used and the tRNAs on the filter were bound to valine. Therefore, the codon GUU specifies valine. Nirenberg and Letter were able to identify 61 codons altogether. And here are the references that were used for making this video.